We'd love to be talking about sports on the field today. February is always a slow time, but we've had a good time this week. Certainly, we can make topics and make them work. But a topic kind of fell out of the sky today when New England Patriots owner Robert Kraft was charged with solicitation of prostitution in Jupiter, Florida. So right away, that comes down and the jokes begin. But then you see the broad scope of what's going on here and the jokes kind of stop dead because this is a wider probe of human sex trafficking, where the women that were working in this quote-unquote massage parlor were brought to this country under the assumption that they were getting legitimate jobs. Then they were brought to this place and forced, this is all alleged, forced to perform sexual acts on customers. Now, supposedly, there's a tape that implicates Robert Kraft in this, and I'm not being flippant about this. I know that when any of these tapes happen, people always want to run to see it. I do not want to see this tape under any stretch of the imagination. Now, the Patriots have come out, and they've said that he is absolutely not guilty of these charges, but the police are saying that there's a tape. Adam Schefter is coming out and saying that this is not even the biggest name in the sting.
You idiot.
So there's where we stand right now, and the NFL has said we're aware of what's going on, monitoring the situation. It's an active investigation, so we will not comment any further. But you would think that Robert Kraft is going to get some kind of punishment for sure. Now, if he had nothing to do with the human sex trafficking, nothing, and was just there to get a massage, and then it went a little further, he's probably not even going to go to jail. Probably be slapped on the wrist and some fine, or that's it. His big punishment might come from the NFL.
You said Jupiter, Florida?
Yep.
Oh, no. I've got some major concerns.
But you do represent the NFL. You represent the New England Patriots. It's an ugly situation for sure, okay? But if Irsay got six for being high on drugs driving a car, then what should Robert Kraft get? Four, three, two? I mean, that's the jumping off point, right? Irsay embarrassed the National Football League. Irsay put everyone that was on the streets when he was driving in jeopardy, right? So that's a lot worse than what Robert Kraft did. Both are bad. Both are bad for the image of the sport, but I can't say that what he did was anywhere close to what Irsay did. So if Irsay got six, what do you give Kraft? But the idea of taking draft picks away, forcing him to sell the team, that's just people that hate the Patriots and want to see them punished because you can't stand their face. But logically, any more than three or four, to me, I think would be excessive compared to what Irsay got.
Now, on a human level, okay, and again, you can't really completely divorce yourself from the fact that there were women that were involved that were forced to be involved. But from a human point of view, you look at a guy married 40-some-odd years. His wife passed away after a long battle with cancer, and he seems to have had, I don't want to call it a midlife crisis. You don't have a midlife crisis in your 70s, but he's dating a 39-year-old, and the guy goes a couple of times to this massage parlor and gets a massage, and it allegedly goes further. So, I mean, you imply your own moral judgment on this.
Right.
All right, so people that live in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. I know that's a cliche, but you can almost tell when people are pulling their punches because they're probably thinking, for the grace of God, right. Go I. Listen, it's reprehensible to pay for that thing. It never has entered my mind in any way, shape, or form since I was a kid.
No.
And thankfully, it never had to, but...
Never entered your mind?
Never. I, you know what? I found it totally objectionable. I didn't even think it was a turn-on.
I believe that. It's never something I've considered either. But I know people who have.
And you sometimes famous, powerful people, because they don't want, you know, the muss or the fuss. It's just a transaction.
Right. And there was just a huge story here in New York, about in Queens, mm-hmm. by Citi Field, I thought. There are these prostitution rings all over the place. That, like, there's a whole history in New York of massage parlors. That they're, from what I've been told, everywhere. Like, if you just keep your eyes open, they're absolutely everywhere. But then there was just a story last week in the newspaper about these people in Queens, and they basically get busted, and then they move and pop up somewhere else. And I don't necessarily fully understand it.
Well, it's the world's oldest profession.
But this is also even, like, I guess it's the same thing as a prostitution ring, but it's almost like, I mean, I guess I don't know what they were doing there. I'm assuming what he was busted for is a completed massage.
Right.
That's what I'm assuming it was.
I guess we shouldn't assume.
I guess we don't know, though.
Yeah,
I mean,
we have no idea.
Because some of these places, they offer everything.
Right.
It's not just that.
But you do know that what you're doing is illegal.
Yes.
In some way, shape, or form. Now, part of the legality of it is to take out the whole investigatory deal that you have to go through, right? Like, should he know that there's human trafficking going on, or is this just some woman that wanted to make a couple of extra bucks? The idea is prostitution's illegal for these reasons, because women are being taken advantage of. There is human trafficking going on. Thus, the reason why prostitution is illegal. One of the reasons, anyway. It's kind of when Lawrence Taylor solicited a prostitute that was underage. Well, it's not his fault. He didn't know she was underage. Well, if you're going to dance with the devil, you've got to live with the circumstances. You're doing something illegal, so it opens the door for you to be at least partially responsible for what happens, right? I mean, so is he responsible for the fact there was human trafficking going on? No, of course not. But when you do something illegal, it's hard to feel bad for you and say, oh, well, just wrong place at the wrong time. No, you knew what was going on, and you still committed a crime in some way, shape, or form. Now, is it as bad as everybody's making it out to be? Is it as bad as what Robert Irsay did? Is it as bad as what Jim Irsay has done? Is it as bad as some other things that have taken place? But it's still something that's illegal and shouldn't have done in the first place, so it's probably punishable. But I can't imagine it would be anywhere close to what Irsay got.
All right, let's listen to Andrew Sharp. He is the detective in Jupiter, and he's talking about Kraft's involvement in this.
So how the 15th Judicial Circuit works is these are misdemeanor crimes. If you live and reside in Palm Beach County, you will receive a notice in the mail saying that you have a summons to appear in court. I can't speak to the exact dollar number that individual paid. However, there is a specific number for a time frame when you are there that you pay. It appears when you go to the spa for a half hour, the fee would be $59. For an hour, that would be $79. The video contained Mr. Kraft inside receiving the alleged X. The answer to that is yes.
Ugh. Here's Jeff Darlington, our very own, on SportsCenter, cautioning that we need to be clear on the charge against Kraft.
Robert Kraft is not being charged with anything to do with human trafficking at this point. It is solicitation of prostitution. It is a misdemeanor. So right now we are talking about misdemeanors as it pertains to Robert Kraft. Again, an incredibly uncomfortable conversation, but one where we need to make clear delineations.
Here's Adam Schefter saying that Kraft will probably be in trouble with the NFL.
Keep in mind that owners, NFL owners, are subject to standards than any NFL employee, and they are subject to the NFL's personal conduct policy. If you go back to 2014, Jim Irsay was suspended 6 games and fined $500,000 after being arrested on drug charges. So now, not only is there an investigation into South Florida, not only do we have an issue that involves women who have been trapped in human trafficking, which is an important distinction to make here, but now the NFL has another situation, another investigation to launch, and it involves obviously one of the most powerful people in all of sports.
And then he goes on and drops this bomb and says that Kraft is not the only famous person involved.
I'm also told that Robert Kraft is not the biggest name involved down there in South Florida, and we'll see what police turn up in the report, but obviously there's a situation that's unfolding here that's disturbing on a number of levels, especially for the woman who have been trapped in human trafficking. I think that's something to point out here that is important to note, that they've been tracking this, the woman who have been trapped in human trafficking, for months now.
The New York Post article here says that in the probe that led to this arrest targeted five massage parlors. where the women were...
All in that general vicinity?
Yes, where the women were living like slaves, servicing an average of 8 clients a day, around 1,500 men a year. The women also had to endure grueling living conditions, including sleeping in the parlors, sleeping on the massage tables, no access to transportation.
You know, there's so many unfortunate parts of this, but I can't sit here and indict Robert Kraft on that stuff. I mean, yeah, he's doing something he shouldn't be doing, but he didn't go in there and go, you know, to the woman giving him a massage, are you being held here against your will? I mean, so he's probably going to get what amounts to a traffic ticket.
Right.
But the NFL is going to punish him much more than our judicial system would punish him for being involved as being a John. That's essentially it.
You know, Carmine sent a tweet that said, Don, I don't agree with you, man. Kraft should get as many games, if not more than Jim. These girls were forced to do sexual acts that got to be just as bad, if not worse, than what Jim Irsay did. I'm always on your side, but not here, man. But did he know that? He's not being charged with trafficking. Did he know that these women are being treated that way? But I can also understand the other side of it, that prostitution's illegal for a large part because of what goes on with these women. So are you de facto somewhat responsible when you decide to dance in that world? You know, so... But what I was saying about Irsay, wasn't he behind the wheel of a car? I mean, he was intoxicated.
No, I mean, there was a lot of nefarious stuff that went on there. I mean, there was a lot. It wasn't just he was caught with drugs.
Right, but there's a lot. Yeah, so he got 6 games. So I can't, but whatever. The fact is, even if it ends up being 6 games, it's not going to be more than that. It shouldn't be more than that. But you're dancing in that world, so there's, I guess, some shade that gets thrown at you for what goes on, but... Peter, we were talking off the air. I mean, if you walk into a bodega to buy beer, are you checking to see if they've got a liquor license? And if they don't, should you be responsible for buying beer from a place that didn't have a liquor license? I mean, so are you? How responsible are you to know?
Yeah, I mean, and I guess you never know, like, how obvious. Maybe these places do seem really sketch.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, you can tell they're not high-end. And that we don't know. I'm just saying we don't know.
Well, I think the worst thing that will come out of this for Kraft, other than a certain length of a suspension by the NFL, is the utter embarrassment of being a multi-billionaire, one of the most respected people in the NFL, a 77-year-old man, and, I mean, he's probably holding his breath till TMZ gets the video. You know that video is going to get out.
Yeah.
And that's going to even be more of a further embarrassment. So this is the worst thing that happened to him today. But, I mean, he's going to be embarrassed in front of his family, his grandchildren, his players. It's going to be a constant joke. It's going to be a punchline. That's a tough day.
Well, to spin it back to sports, what is so interesting to me is this iconic franchise, this dynasty, is stained tremendously over its length of the dynasty.
Whether it's
Spygate, whether it's Deflategate, and now you have, you know, the owner.
Well, you forgot the most
busted
the
worst thing.
Aaron Hernandez. I mean, the things that Aaron Hernandez did, and they gave him a big term contract. I mean, that's a lifetime movie in itself.
Yeah, so it's amazing. So all along the way, championship after championship, this incredible dynasty, you can write a book and not even touch the field on the things that have gone on behind closed doors, and a lot of it spins towards the owner.
You know what's amazing? And you can't take this out of the equation. If you take the 6 Super Bowls out of the equation, this looks like the worst dumpster fire in professional sports history.
This is a perfect example on why winning really cures everything.
It's a great deodorant.
Every controversy, because we've seen teams get busted for doing
it. It's more than deodorant.
Things.
It's like an identity. It's like it changes your entire identity.
Absolutely.
The Atlanta Falcons have lost draft picks for pumping in artificial sound during games. The Cleveland Browns were jumped because of illegally sending text messages during games. Nobody cared because those teams didn't win championships because of it, right? So, but when you win, it's the ultimate deodorant. As you said, it just completely looks like they kind of overcome these things, not about these things, but they just pile up. They pile up almost as high as the winning. I mean, every major controversy the NFL seems to be around, and what percentage of it has involved the Patriots in some way, shape, or form?
It's amazing. It really is amazing because it's thought of as the Tiffany franchise,
right.
and it's really not.
No, they,
the
they,
Tiffany is the winning. The other stuff.
The only gate they haven't been involved in was Watergate and Bountygate.